Hi, hey everybody, my name is Auriel Fournier. I'm a postdoc at Mississippi State University, and I'm here today to talk with you about my poster. So what we're talking about today is some really neat whale work that took place just here in Northwest Ohio at Ottawa National Wildlife Refuge back in 2004 to 2009. And so what we're doing is we're taking trapping data from these traps that have audio lures, so they have playback that's played at night to draw the birds in, and we're trying to see what impact that has on how early during spring migration we're actually detecting the birds' arrival. And so we've got this graph here, it's three different species of rail. King rail, Sora, and Virginia rail. A couple important things to know. King rail are state endangered in Ohio, and we have a very, very small sample size. So there's not a whole lot we can say about this graph other than here are some descriptive data. For Sora and Virginia rail, we're dealing with pretty good sample sizes, and we have some pretty interesting results. So since we're just comparing the initiation of spring migration, we're also comparing to historical data and to eBird data that was collected at the same site over the same years. These dark blue dots are from 1926. And so while they're interesting and we're glad that we have them, we're not really sure how comparable our data from 04 to 09 is to 1926 data. What we're really interested in is comparing our data, dark green dots, which are eBird data from the same range of years. And so what we're seeing here for Sora and for Virginia rail is that these purple dots are earlier than the eBird data, okay? And so what that means is that when you're using an audio lure, you're detecting the birds as they're first arriving, as opposed to eBird, which is a great resource, but when the birders are just going out, they're not catching those first arriving individuals, which is really important when we're talking about when we survey for birds and how we manage them. So I'm Auriel. This is really great work that came out of Flagstaff Bird Observatory, which is at BSBO Bird on Twitter, or you can ask me any questions at @rabbitbird.